मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वार्म वेलकम। दिस इज डॉक्टर एन विजय, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर, भारत इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ लॉ, भारत इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च। माय टॉपिक इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड आई एम गोइंग टू टेक लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी। ओके, we know the term about law of diminishing marginal utility. What is the meaning of utility? Okay, the simple meaning of utility is usefulness. Simple meaning of utility is usefulness. Okay, in economics, utility is the capacity of a commodity to satisfy human wants, because wants are unlimited. We want to match the wants. Okay, wants are unlimited. Okay, the person wants to satisfy his or her own desires. Okay, utility is the quality in goods to satisfy human wants. Thus, it is said that wants satisfying capacity of goods or services is called utility. Okay, wants satisfying capacity of good or service is called utility. Here, a consumer buy or demand a particular commodity. He derives some benefits from his use. He feels that his given want is satisfied by the use or consumption of the commodity purchased. So they're satisfied by the use or consumption of the commodity purchased. So he used to satisfy his wants. Okay, wants are satisfied with the help of consumption, use of goods and services. So utility is the basis of consumer demand. A consumer think about his demand for a commodity on the basis of utility derived from the commodity. So utility is the basis of consumer demand, because depends upon the consumer demand, can be vary from time to time. Okay, definition of utility. So according to Wall, utility is the power of commodity to satisfy human wants. So utility is the power of commodity to satisfy human wants. So according to Prasser, on the whole, in recent years, the wider definition is preferred with, and utility is identified with desiredness rather than with satisfyingness. Can utility measure? Is it possible? Yes, utility is a psychological concept. Utility is a psychological concept. This is different from different people. It depends upon the mindset of the consumer. The consumer wants to satisfy the commodity. Okay, depends upon the time limit. Therefore, it cannot be measured directly. We can't measure directly. Professor Marshall has said that utility can be measured, and its measuring rod is money. So we can measure utility with the help of money. So the price which are ready to pay for an article is particularly its price. Price is the measuring value. Okay, price is the measuring value. So with the help of the price, the utility of the commodity can be increased or decreased. So nobody will be prepared to pay more than the utility which we derive from the article, So the law of diminishing utility. So the law of diminishing marginal utility. This is a familiar and a fundamental tendency of human behavior. So the law of diminishing utility states that, assumes that as a consumer consumes more and more utility of a specific commodity. So the utility from the successive units goes on diminishing. Mr. H. Gosen, a German economist, was the first person to explain the law in the year 1854. So Alfred Marshall later restated his law in the following words. The additional benefit which a person derives from an increase of his stock of a thing diminishes. With every increase in the stock that already has. Okay, So the total utility the commodity can be increased, but the marginal utility of the commodity can be reduced. So the additional benefit which a person derived from an increase of his stock, the total utility of the commodity can be increased of a thing, diminished with every increase in the stock that already has. Okay. So the law is purely based on three facts. First, total wants of a man are unlimited. So total wants of a man are unlimited, but each single wants can be satisfied. So a man gets more and more units of commodity, So the desire of his for the goods goes on falling. So a point is reached when the consumer no longer wants any more unit of that commodity. So because wants are unlimited, the person wants to satisfy his wants. So based on certain variables, if it is possible or not, he try to satisfy his or her own wants. Okay, secondly, different goods are not perfect substitute. For each other. So in the satisfaction of various particular wants. As such, the marginal utility will decline. As a consumer gets additional unit of a specific good, that is more important regarding the utility analysis. Thirdly, the marginal utility of money is constant. Given the consumer wealth. Okay. So the basic of the law is a fundamental feature of wants. Okay, is that when people go to the market for purchase of commodities, they don't attend equal importance to all the commodities which they buy. Because all consumers are rational, so they never measure this type of attitude. Okay, sometimes it may vary from person to person. So in case of some commodities, they are willing to pay more and same less. So there are two main reasons for different in demand. First one, the link of consumer for the commodity. Second one, the quality of the commodity which the consumer has with himself. Okay. So in other words, the marginal utility of a commodity diminishing. As the consumer gets larger quantities of it. Okay, assumptions. Number one, first and foremost assumption, rationality. So in the cardinality analysis, so it is assumed that consumer is rational. He aims at maximization of utility subject to availability of his income. So income play a vital role for maximizing utility. We can accept this concept because income is a vital factor, judgment factor. Okay, it can create the demand as well as supply of the product. So the consumer wants to purchase the commodity with the help of the income. Okay, next, constant marginal utility of money. So it is assumed that the theory that the marginal utility of money based on purchasing goods remaining constant. So if the marginal utility of money changes with the increase or decrease in income, so income is the vital factor for purchasing of goods and services. It will increase the utility. If the income of the person is increased, he wants to increase its utility. If income of the consumer reduced, he wants to reduce its or decrease its utility. So then it cannot then can't yield correct measure of the marginal utility of good. So diminishing marginal utility. So another important assumption of utility analysis is that the utility gained from the successive units. Utility gained from the successive units of a commodity. Diminution in a given time period. Okay, number five, consumption to be continuous. So the consumption of a commodity should be continuous. If there is interval between the consumption of the same unit of the commodity, the utility may not hold good. For instance, if you take one glass of water, so in the morning and in the second at noon, so the marginal utility of the glass of water may increase. So there is a class interval, time interval is there. If the person wants to take one unit of water at morning, so after that he wants to take second unit at noon, so there is a time gap, time is there. Okay, number six, suitable quantity. So the commodity consumed is taken, that the commodity consumed is taken in suitable and reasonable units. If the units are too small, then the marginal utility instead of falling may increase up to few units. So the character of the consumer does not change. So that now hold true if there is no change in the character of the consumer. For example, if a consumer develop a taste for wine, so the additional unit of wine may increase the marginal utility to a drinker. Okay, so we can know about the ordinary human being. So we don't want mentally retarded man or addicted people. Okay, so the theory is purely based on the rationality behavior of the human being. That is more important here. Okay, so we can't assume, we can't know about, we cannot measure what mentally retarded person as well as addiction people. Okay, no change to fashion, customs and taste. If there is a sudden change in fashion, customs or taste of a consumer, so it can make the law inoperative. So no change in the price of the commodity, there should be any change in the price of the commodity as more unit are consumed or most unit of consumed. So explanation, so the law, this law can be explained by taking a very example, simple example. Suppose a man is very thirsty, so he goes to market and buy one glass of sweet water. So the glass of water gives him immense pleasure. We say that the first glass of water has great utility for him. If he takes second glass of water, that the utility will be less than that of the first one. It is because the edge of this thirsty has been blunted to a great extent. If he drinks third glass of water, the utility of the third glass will be less than that of second one, and so on. It is a cyclical process because the person wants to take particular commodity at continuous. There is no time lag for using that particular good. So the person wants to take continuous. Okay, if the consumer is forced further to take a glass of water, it leads to disutility, causing total utility to decline. So the marginal utility became negative. The total utility of the commodity is increased, but the marginal utility will be negative. So a rational consumer will stop taking water at the point at which marginal utility became negative, even if the good is free. So in short, the more we have a thing, ceteris paribus, that is other things being equal, there is no change in the market, other things being remains constant, so less we want, still more of that are to be more precise. In given span of time, the more of a specific product a consumer obtain, the less anxious he is to get more units of that product. Or we can say that as more unit of a good are consumed, additional units will provide less additional satisfaction than the previous units. So schedule of law of diminishing marginal utility. Okay, so first utility, total utility, marginal utility, first glass Total utility of the commodity 20, marginal utility of the commodity also second class. Total utility of the commodity 32. Okay, marginal utility of the commodity 20 minus 32 remains 12. Third glass, the person wants to take third glass of water. Total utility of the commodity 40. The marginal utility of the commodity is 8 when we compare to 32 minus 40. The difference between 32 minus 40. Fourth glass. If the person wants to take one more additional unit, fourth glass of water, okay, the total utility of the commodity gives 42. The marginal utility of the commodity is 40 minus 42 equal to 2. Fifth class. So there is no change because it gives 42 total utility. So the marginal utility of the commodity is 0. So after that, he is willing to take another more unit. Sixth class. It reduced from 42 to 39. Okay. So the marginal utility of the commodity is negative, that is minus 3. Because the first unit of the glass gives more level of marginal utility when we compare to sixth glass. Okay. So from the above table, it is clear that in a given span of time, the first glass of water to a thirsty man gives 20 units of utility. When he takes a second glass of water, the marginal utility goes down to 12 units. When he consumes a fifth unit, glass of water, the marginal utility drops from zero. Okay, there is no change. Zero. If the consumption of water is forced further, point, that is sixth point. So the utility changes into disutility, that is minus 3, negative. So the total utility of the commodity increased, but the marginal utility of the commodity decreased. Here it may notice that the utility then successive unit consumed diminishes. Not because they are not of inferior in quality than that of others. So we assumed that all the units of commodity consumes are exactly alike. So the utility of successive units fall simply because they happen to be consumed afterwards. So there is the person wants to take continuous units of water. So there is no time lag. So that the psychological aspect of the human beings will operate. So in the initial stage, the first glass gives more level of satisfaction than more level of utility. When we compare to second unit, third unit, at that particular point, there is no utility. After that, it gives negative. Okay, that is the symbol. If the person wants to take one glass, it gives 20, first glass, second glass, 12, third glass, 18, fourth glass, 4, fifth glass, and sixth glass. So it is negative in nature. It is look like a demand schedule. It's like a demand schedule from left to right. It is look like a demand schedule from left to right. Okay. So the in the figure above figure 2.2 along y-axis we measured the utility of the commodity consumed and along OY is show the marginal utility derived from them. So the marginal utility of the first glass of water is called initial utility. The first time he is going to take. So there is the person don't know about the quality of the good. Okay, he wants to take more because he is thirsty. So he wants to take that particular commodity. It is equal to 20 units. The MU, the marginal utility of fifth glass water is 0. So it is called station point. Station point or break-even point. Okay. So the marginal utility of sixth glass of water is negative. Is negative in nature. So the marginal utility curve lies below y-axis. So the curve MM falls left from left down to right, showing that the marginal utility of the successive unit of glass water is falling. What are the limitations? So case of intoxicants. The consumption of liquid defines the low of a short period. So the more a person drinks, the more likes it. However, this is a stunner only instantly. A stage comes when a drunkard too starts taking less and less liquor and eventually stopped it. It's a rare collection. If there are only two diamonds in the world, the passion of second diamond will push up the marginal utility. Push up the marginal utility. That is called as the identity of the product. The product has value. The product has a superior value. Okay. Application to money. The law equals hold good for money. Holds good for money. It is true that the more money the man has, the greater. Okay. Greedier he is to get additional unit of it. Greedier he is to get additional unit of it. However, the truth is that the marginal utility of money declines the richness, but never falls to zero. Never falls to zero. So before that, we want to know about utility. So utility of the commodity is purely depends upon the satisfaction of the person. Depends upon the psychological attitude of the person. Okay, utility can be measured in money value. Money value. So sometimes the utility of the commodity can be measured, or increase in the utility of the commodity can be measured or induced by the price of the commodity. So the price of the commodity is the vital factor for inducing the utility of the commodity. So if the price of the commodity is low, the consumer wants to purchase more commodity at a time, if income level permits. So it is not applicable for all. Some of the consumer can purchase some commodities. Okay, some of the consumer can purchase certain commodities. That is the vital factor. Here we state that the person wants to have the particular product, the particular good continuously. There is no time lag. So time lag play a vital role for deciding the marginal utility of the commodity. Okay, if there is no change in the price of the commodity, the consumer wants to take a continuous intake of the particular commodity. So the total utility of the commodity is increased 20, 32, 40, 42, like this. Okay. But the marginal utility of the commodity decreased 20, 12, 5, 3, 2, like this. In certain stages, there is no increase in the total utility. So 42 as well as 42. So there is no change in the product. That is called zero utility. Zero utility. The utility of the commodity is equal to zero. After a certain point, it gives negative result to the user. Okay. So the first and foremost point, other things being constant. So there is no change in the external operations. There is no change in the external operations like taste, preference, satisfaction of the consumer. So identical product of the consumer. The consumer has no substitute of the commodity. So the mindset of the person is, the mindset of the particular person remains constant. He is be strong. Okay. That utility of the commodity use, utility of the particular commodity use more satisfaction or more utils. The consumer wants to satisfy more at the initial stage, So he wants to maximize. So it is purely measured in terms of money. Money is the measuring value. Money is the rod of measurement. Money is the store of value. We can measure utility with the help of money. Money matters. So based on cardinal utility analysis. Okay. Is there any clarification? I think we don't have any doubt at all. Okay. Thank you. We will meet soon.